Watchers out, along with these wicked giants. However, some of the fallen angels survive and fled to other countries where they continue to teach mankind occult secrets. The Watchers were never destroyed, and their secret knowledge was spread across various cultures. Many would say that their knowledge has survived up until even this day. God resolved to be just. For this, it was necessary for him to select people who were without stain and who would be allowed to survive this weeding out with the flood. His method of selection was a simple one. He chose people who still were pure at heart. His choice was Noah and his family. Noah is described in Genesis 6:9, quote, Noah was a righteous man, blameless among the people of his time, and he walked faithfully with God. Noah had three sons, Shem, Ham, and Japheth. The people of his time, or generations here, is kind of an imperfect translation of the Hebrew word to ed-ah, which means ancestry, in case you needed to know that. So, an earlier and more appropriate translation is Noah was a just man and perfect without blemish in his generations. He was God's choice because he and his family were the last remaining pure-blooded Adamites in the world. The story of Noah and the Great Flood is never really told the right way. It's either made into a comedy like Evan Almighty, or it's made into a cutesy little kid's book with cute little animals getting on the ark and, you know. Or into a cute little Russell Crowe movie that wasn't nearly as good as Gladiator, and he ends up trying to kill his family.
That was such a bizarre
movie. Very weird.
It's really weird.
Let's talk about that for a second. So the 2014 film Noah was more on the right path. In some ways, it was a darker, more gritty version of the story. Although it was an entertaining film, they absolutely missed some key points.
Oh, yeah.
Leave it to a Hollywood film to obscure the truth to an important story.
And like, what was the giants? Like, these giant rock things? Like, the...
Well, but I don't even know what those were supposed to be. The
Nephilim, the giants? I don't even know. It's like, oh, well, instead of giants, let's have these, like, rock creatures that are not...
Or were they the Watchers, or who knows?
That whole movie was just really...
Watchers.
Yeah, although the premise was there, but...
Yeah.
This, I don't know. It was weird. No one liked it. No one on any religion liked it. Anyway, so in the movie, the Watchers were portrayed as the good guys, those weird rock things that we're kind of talking about. Like, I guess these are the fallen angels who were just trying to help humans get on the right path. Why they were looked like rock beings, we have no idea. But in the end, they were punished by God for trying to help.
Of course, in Hollywood, they'd make the Watchers look like the good guys. They then take the form of these rock giants and help Noah build his ark. The Watchers are eventually called back to heaven after defending the ark. And as we just learned in this episode, that isn't the way it went down at all.
We'll get into more of Noah's story in the next episode. So what actually happened during the flood? Well, I mean, there's not really too much to tell, really. I mean, a giant flood came through the whole earth, it seems like, and flooded and killed a bunch of people and continents and things like that. So it's really about what happened after the flood that's important.
Yeah, we know that no one in the entertainment industry is going to give it to you straight, so we will.
We'll also be getting into the great evil empire that was Babylon. That can only be compared to Mordor from Lord of the Rings, and their Sauron-like leader, Nimrod.
So here's the bonus. Merry Christmas, you filthy animals. So, oh man, you guys, we've got some information that might make us ruin Christmas again.
Yeah, or maybe make you so upset that it makes you want to punch a mall Santa.
Dude, what are you talking about?
Actually, should be more like red pill Santa, right? Yeah. Makes you want to go up to Santa and be like, yeah. Hey, Santa, let me red pill you on what's really going on.
No one's punching mall Santa's here. That's me.